Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel, What the Curry. I am not sure how many people have heard about this. This is very popular Punjabi North Indian dish called Bangan ka Bharta. It is made with smoky roasted eggplant and with lot of Indian spicy. Come on, let's begin this. Here I have used 3 eggplants. You're going to use the bigger ones. And then some finely chopped onions. I have finely chopped tomato. This is 1.5 tomatoes. Tomato puree. Then I have fresh coriander for garnishing. Finely chopped ginger and finely chopped green chilies and some garlic cloves. These are all the ingredients for Bangan Bharta, that is eggplant mash. First and foremost, we're gonna prep how we're gonna roast these eggplants. Okay, we're gonna dress it with little bit of oil in it. Any cooking oil would do. Just put it all over the eggplant and with a knife just cut it like that. Don't cut it fully, just so that you can have an opening on it. That's it. And then to get that nice roasty flavor, I usually like to put the garlic cloves inside this opening like this. So I'm going to dress all my 3 eggplants like these. Put the cooking oil, nicely dress it up with it, not too much. Take the knife, cut it in half like this, and then put the garlic cloves inside it. That's it. Some people actually use the oven to roast the eggplants. I do have a tip to do it. In India, we used to directly put it on the flame, but this is what I do. I use an old frying pan. You can use a new one, but usually an old one is better, because what happens is when you roast the eggplants, it gets quite messy. So I would recommend to use an old frying pan like this rather than directly putting on the flame. This is a really good tip to try. In past, when I used to put it directly on the stove, it used to leave a lot of moisture and it used to ruin my stovetop. So I think this is a great way to do it. You must try this. Roasting an eggplant would take a while. So while it's doing that, let's get into the next thing, which is making the masala. The spices, we call it tadka. So take a pan, put a little bit of oil in it, approximately 2 tablespoons. While it's getting hot, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds. Let it splatter, maybe a little bit more. And then I'm going to add red chili powder as per your taste. Here I have added Kashmiri red chili, which isn't very spicy. So it just adds a nice color to the dish. I'm gonna mix it a little bit, and then we can add this finely chopped red onions. You can also use white onions, up to you. This is approximately 1.5 to 2 red onions. Now the idea is to cook these red onions, make it transparent, probably a little bit more than transparent, light golden brown. If you guys want to see how to chop these red onions, I do have a YouTube video to see how you can finely chop these red onions. But I think you really need a very good knife for it to work. Anyways, I'm going to cook these. See how it's cooking. While this is cooking, my eggplants is roasting on the next side. I'm getting a very nice fragrance of roasting eggplants and cooking onions. Okay, we're going to do the next thing. We're going to add few more ingredients into the onions. So these are green chilies. Again, add it to your taste. I have de-seeded them. You can actually use, depends on your spices basically. And then you add this finely chopped ginger. I highly recommend to add these fresh chopped gingers. It actually adds a very nice flavor to this eggplant mash or Bangan Bharta. I'm going to cook it a little bit more. What I tend to do is cook it till the oil separate is my rule for anything cooking. I know it's cooked once the oil separates. I'm trying to multitask here. Eggplants are roasting over here and then I'm cooking my tadka, my curry, my masala, whatever you like to call it. Because these eggplants is going to take a while, what I'm going to do is I'm going to concentrate on the eggplant till it roasts and turn off the pan for a while. So I'm going to turn over these eggplants like this. You can actually see that it's cooked from one side and it's actually in a high flame. There you go, you can see it's actually nicely cooked and it actually has a really nice aroma while it's cooking. So I'm going to turn over all the three of them and then leave it again for another 5 to 10 minutes. This is a long process and I think that's what it takes longer to make these eggplant roast. You will see in the later part of the videos why I'm using an old frying pan, because this eggplant would actually gonna leave a lot of moisture that could actually ruin your fry pan. The best way to tell that it's fully roasted is when the skin actually becomes quite flaky, quite crispy. That's when you know the inside is also cooked. It's still a little bit left on it because you can see it's still quite soft. It doesn't have that crispiness. There you go, this side is actually done. I'm gonna twist it over like this and then hopefully another 4 to 5 minutes it'll be fully cooked. The other way to tell that it's fully cooked, you can actually see the inside color is not white anymore. It's actually turned yellow and see how stunning it looks. It has actually got a really nice roasty flavor with that garlic on it. And see how much moisture it has taken out. Okay, I'm gonna take it out on a plate because I need to peel the skin off. The skin actually comes out quite easily once it's nicely crispy on the outside. Just be careful that don't burn your hands. Once these are out, the other tip that I'd like to mention here is I would like to take the skin off while it's in this temperature. So it's really important you do it like this, because what happens is this skin actually gets stuck to the eggplant and then it gets really difficult to take it out when it's cold. So here I'm going to take one by one. You can see all the steam coming out. It's still actually quite hot. There you go. I'm going to take it off like that. I like to use sometimes a fork or a knife just so that I don't burn my hand. See how easily it's coming because it's nice and crispy outside. And it doesn't matter if a little bit of the skin goes into the curry. It doesn't ruin the taste. I'll show you why I like to use the fork or a knife, because sometimes when you take it out, you can actually scrape out the inner eggplant into it. Like what I just did. So I'm slowly gradually opening this. I actually wanted to show you how I do it fully. I'm gonna turn it over now. Okay, it's almost there. I'm gonna take this off, and if it actually comes out like this, just scrape it through with a spoon or a fork or a knife. And that's it. Okay, the whole skin is out and that's the leftover eggplant, the roasted one. I'm gonna do all three of these like this. I think you got the idea, you can do it now. I'm not gonna show another one to do this, but you can see they're still steaming hot and it's actually giving a really, really amazing fragrance of roasted eggplant. There you go. Also, I wanted to show you the garlic. It's actually quite soft. Look how soft it is. It's going to easily mash. So don't take it out. Put it with the other eggplants. The next thing is I'm going to mash it up. So these are all the three eggplants. Like you can still see the steam, it's quite hot right now. What I tend to do is while it's hot, I'm going to mash it. So I like to use the fork for that. If you want, you can use your hands as well. Forks are easy because it's actually quite hot right now. So just do it like that. Sometimes you do the baby food like this as well. So it's pretty much based on the same technique. There you go. Please do not use a blender to do this. We don't want it to make it a paste. We just want to mash it and get a nice texture out of it. Okay, now we can take our pan and start finishing it. Here is my eggplant roast done nicely. Okay, so now here we have all this onion, ginger and green chili cooking, and you can see the oil is separated. That means all the moisture from the onion has gone, and now we can do the next thing, which is adding other stuff. Okay, I'm going to add now that finely chopped tomatoes. This is small 1.5 tomatoes. Now mix it with the onions and cook it a little bit, not too much. The next thing is add a small bowl of tomato puree. This is really good to do it because this adds that red color to the dish, to this eggplant roast or bangan bharta. You should always keep this in mind. Whenever you add tomatoes, make sure you add salt to it. Okay, I'm going to add the salt to taste. This is 1 teaspoon salt. I'm going to cook it for another 3 to 4 minutes. You don't need to cover it. Just cook it like this. I can almost see the oils getting separated. That means tomato is almost cooked. We're just going to add a little bit more dry masalas to it. Okay, the dry masalas are, this is coriander powder. I'm going to add 2 heapful teaspoon of coriander powder into this like this, and then 1 teaspoon of garam masala. You can get this from any Indian grocery. In fact, a lot of other grocery stores also have these. It's quite commonly used now. Indian cooking has actually become quite famous in a lot of countries. Now is the finishing touch. We're going to add this eggplant, roasted eggplant, into this, the mashed ones that we just did. That's it. The eggplant is cooked, the masala is cooked. Now we're just going to mix it up. Please, please, please do not cook more, because this is exactly the time that you just mix it up and turn off the gas. That's it. It's ready to eat. Oh my god, it's got such a nice aroma to it. It's actually making my mouth so watery. This is actually served with roti or naan. I've also seen some people eat it as a side dish, especially with dal and chawal. That's it. Nothing much to do. It's actually nicely cooked, oil is separated, it's actually looking really good. Now I'm gonna serve it in the platter. I hope you like this recipe, and please do like and subscribe to our channel. Share it with your friends and family. Do try, and if you try and if you like, do let us know how was it. In our house, we like to eat bangan ka bharta, that is eggplant mash, with a nice roti. And then we also like to put a side to it like a raita or a dahi. Keep watching our channel, What the Curry. Bye for now.